Alright.
In the last episode, we defeated the second boss of the game. And so we're going on in this new area. So if you have to use the same enemies here, they give you a new enemy, Risky. And if you consider it an enemy, that must be really bad at the game, because, well, I was going to say you could jump right over it, but here you can. It's gonna be... And here is the next new enemy with this arrow, that's the follower. As you can guess, it follows. And it's annoying, really hard to hit. But now, let's get on to the most awesome music of this game. Wow. This is probably some bad audio. Alright, so here is where this place gets its namesake. This is Magmoor. It's a fire-breathing lava snake, I guess. If you want to use as many words to describe this thing as you can, you could. Yeah, see? Just cutting out a little bit. Yeah, those guys will be easier later on with some new weapons. Here we have the puffer. These guys kind of just float around, but when you shoot them, they explode into toxic gas. Yeah. Yeah, if you touch them, they explode too. It's best to just kind of get through this really fast. Because it's sort of annoying, and the fact that the platforms do sink into the lava, and you got those guys flying around, and itch on my face, and then I like a troll stick and start rolling backwards. See, look. These guys are so easily avoided. They're not even worth being called enemies. I don't know who put doors down. Alright, now here is the most annoying enemy of the caverns, Triclops, because they do this. I just want to demonstrate that. They're that evil, but they even block the entrance. Anyways, after finally getting through that room, this is probably going to go super fast. I like to speed through Magmoor caverns. Because, I don't know, it's just a really dull looking area being that it's all colored red. You know, red, you can smell it, it's not colored black, but yeah, this area is pretty dull looking. It's really, I mean, the music's good. It's really sort of give everything a wide berth. Am I not giving you a wide enough berth? And other robotic versions of these enemies in the next Metroid Prime, there's robotic boxes. I don't know, they always have some sort of enemy that lives in pits like that to make more fall more harder. Anyways, most people don't know, a lot of people didn't know about this when the game first came out. I know I didn't until I had a game guide for it. There's a secret room hidden back here, this little cage in it, and in the back, it's a missile expansion. Eventually you'll get a missile expansion. Or you can just walk around circles for long enough and then hope to get a missile expansion. Alright, yeah, that's the first missile expansion of the caverns. And we're at 50 missiles already. And I believe that's around halfway there. Maybe a third. Some fraction. I think there's like 120 missiles that you can carry. This is actually helpful. Those tend to throw you into things, like the inside of the pipe. You can't get me up here. Hit a lot of you. To show that we've gone from possibly the highest, possibly the highest point in the game, all the way down to inside this mountain, which means that this core of the earth, which has a rainforest built on top of it. And on top of that, there's also a mountain with a city on it, because that's how I'm going to stack the walls here. Alright, see, look, I told you the auto defense stars would be back, but this time they're stronger. And they take two missiles now. Which, oddly enough, so do their actual tougher brethren, the Megatart. That's what I thought those were the first time I saw them. They didn't die in one hit. I was like, ooh, Megatart. That's a nice effect that we do with the divisor going crazy. We do another effect where the divisor goes staticky in this game, which is pretty cool. Which is law of effect for a 2003-ish game. All I know is that this game, it's after the first game, its timeline actually sort of matches up with the release dates of the Halo series, because Halo 2 and Metroid Prime 2 both came out in the same year, and so did Halo 3 and Metroid Prime 3. So I don't know. Oh, yeah, here we go. Here's the hard part. I hate this, but you gotta do it. About 6 minutes. Yeah, see? I'm going to die here. I already did myself the favor of ruining my chances even more. Alright, so here we go. Wasting my time with 10 minutes. I can go to 15. There we go. No! But yeah, you are a solo. No. And the lava drains your HP. Why did I stop rolling to the left? Anyway. Alright. My nunchuck was doing a thing that temporarily doesn't work. I'm gonna spend a whole video in this room. You should stop and come back. Yeah. I'm thinking of stopping and coming back. Here we go. Never mind. Guess we'll get it. Alright. And through here, after getting that energy tank, I believe that's the only two things we can get there. We get an elevator. Yay! An elevator, guys. Can you believe it? Take the elevator to the surface, see what's going on over here. Doo-doo-doo. I like how she just kind of looks around like, man, at least this doesn't play elevator music. What? Wow, what a contrast. We just got out of, like, one extreme to the other here. I think I just heard someone die. So yeah, basically I cleared that tunnel. And then, we already get a new area intro? Well, this place is really nice. I love this world. This place is my favorite. I mean, look at that. Water. This place has got it all. Oh, but then again, I like when they change the improvement, and there's little holographic platforms and panels in here. Let's read one. New personnel must report to the South Research Facility. Failure report will be penalized by 3% ration cut and extra duty. I wonder what they're talking about. Well, we'll find out in a couple parts. So, that'll be next time on Let's Play Metroid Prime. Epic.